StoryBots learn to read. I want you to know the two sounds of O. There's the short and long sound. Here's how they go. The short goes ah, and the long goes O. They're the sounds of O. Letter O is short in mom and pop, and in a box with a lock, and a dog named Spot. When letter O is short, you hear that aw, like a knot, or pot, or dot. Letter O is long, like in snow and cone, or any time it sounds like the letter O. Like in a hole, that's a gopher's home. That's the long sound of O. I want you to know the two sounds of the short and long sound. Here's how they go. The short goes ah, and the long goes oh. They're the sounds of oh. How do you turn a cup into cups? How do you turn a pup into lots and lots of playful pups? Can you turn a lollipop to lollipops?
Why, yes.
You turn one thing into two or more by adding an S. An S can turn a tree into trees, a bee into a hive of bees, a block into a stack of blocks, a shoe to shoes, a sock to socks. But what about a word like bus or glass or brush or dress? Well, you're often gonna need an E before that S. So you can turn a box into boxes, and you can turn a fox into a den of friendly foxes, a dish to piles of dishes to, my goodness, what a mess. And you can turn a peach to peaches just by adding ES. In your reading and your writing, now you're sure to have success. Changing one to two or more by adding S or ES. Adding S or ES. How deep is the ocean? Why do trees have bark? Where is Timbuktu? Aren't you glad we've got a question mark? When you're writing a question, how do you show it's a question?
With a question mark.
Dear Jane, how have you been? And when you're reading a question, how do you know it's a question?
There's a question mark.
Oh, I'm great. How are you doing? In every written question, there's a question mark at the end. Yeah, when you've got a question, the question mark is your best friend. May I have a cookie?
Ooh, can I?
Would you please share? You can recognize a question when a question mark is there. What is Lunar New Year? Why is nighttime dark? We're full of questions, aren't we? Yeah, don't you love that question mark? Ding dong, jingling song, what do those words all share? If you check the spelling of each, you'll see there's an NG in there. Wedding rings, penguin wings, they're NGs everywhere. Yep, anytime that you hear that ng, there's an NG in there. Even now you may be noticing, just from hearing this song, often NG comes at the end of a word. Well, that's good thinking. You're not wrong. Some of those end with an ING and say things that we're doing, like running, jumping, hiking, humming, kissing, or snowshoeing. But sometimes it's in the middle of a word, like kangaroo and hummingbird. So many things, from gushing springs to swinging rocking chairs. Yep, any time that you hear that ng, there's an NG in there. A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y. The vowels are A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y. Every word needs at least one vowel, as you will plainly see. A pet would just be p without the vowel known as E. A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y. You need a vowel to go with when saying hi. They're the sounds that ring out loud and clear in every word you'll ever hear. And names like Bo, Beep, and Bing all need their vowels to make them sing. Beautiful. A, sometimes why. There's no doubt that you can learn them if you try. In cat and hen and pig and dog and bugs that skitter by, you'll see A, E, I, O, U and sometimes why. Sing along now. A, E, I, O, U and sometimes why. A sounds short and long, fun to learn in a silly song. Just listen now to what I say. The short goes A and the long goes A. The short A makes it sound in cap. Make it long and now it's cape. With a short A you can have a nap. With a long A you can tame an ape. A sounds short and long. Don't stop now, we're going strong. In little words like dad and day. The short goes A and the long goes A. A is short and ran and long in rain. Short in candy, long in cane. These two sounds in letter A make me dance and shout hooray. A sounds short and long. Now you know them, you can't go wrong. When you read words like head and hay, the short goes A and the long goes A. L and E just love a good cuddle. Sometimes those two letters become a couple and make an ull like the end of puddle. That's the final L-E. It's there when you're hungry and you need a little nibble.
Or playing basketball and you're learning how to dribble.
You can write it, but please don't scribble. That's the final L-E. It goes ull. The L does the talking, the E doesn't make a sound. You hear it in words like hey, diddle-diddle. The cat's gonna fiddle around. You gotta use that sound every time you blow a bubble. Now blow another one just to make it a double. And from now on you'll have no trouble hearing the final L-E. That little two-letter ending that we call the final L-E. Pull, hustle, pull, wriggle, pull, puzzle, pull, squiggle, pull, muzzle, pull. That's the final L-E. Have you heard of the bossiest letter around? When he follows a vowel, he changes its sound. You see him in foreign, in fur, and in far. The letter they call bossy R. When he bosses a vowel, a cat becomes cart. A spot is a sport, even at becomes art. With E, I, and U, he can make the sound R. In fern, and in turn, and in sir.
Sir!
Yo ho! He sails to the port. A shot from his cannon will always be short. With a bird on his shoulder, he sails by a star. The letter they call bossy R. In the morning at breakfast, he sits at the stern. He orders a bun that's so hot it will burn. He sails in a storm when the sky is all dark. And he's never afraid of a shark. Yo ho, he sails all around, bossing the vowels and changing their sounds. He's bossy in shirt and in fort and guitar. The letter they call bossy R.
R.
The letter they call bossy R.
R.
The TH sound is kind of a thrill. I think you'll agree, cause here's the deal.
When those letters get together, guess what you got?
A th-th-th. Huh, who would have thought?
Right.
There's a TH sound at the start of throw.
Whoa.
And think and thaw.
Huh.
And this and though. And many words that you know.
Oh.
And sometimes there's TH in the middle of words. Like feather.
Or mother. Or weather.
Oh, brother, get it together. And sometimes TH sounds come at the end. Do the math. Start by counting north, south, path, and bath. And ever notice how sometimes it makes a buzz, sorta?
Yeah.
Like in there, and then.
That's T and H for ya.
Yeah, right now I think it's sinking in. How T and H stick with ya through thick and thin. And when they get together, now you know what they do.
They go tha, tha, tha. Now our lesson is through.
Theo thinks that this month's third Thursday is Thelma's 13th birthday.
C-A-T, that spells cat. And M-A-T spells mat. And S-A-T spells sat. The cat sat on the mat. F-A-T, the cat is fat. H-A-T, he wears a hat. B-A-T, he swings a bat. Imagine that. An S sound plus a T makes at. That will stay the same. Add different sounds to make new words. That's how you play the sat word game. Like C for cat and S for sat. It's easy, yes indeed. You're sounding out those letters and before
before you know it, you can read. C-A-T still spells cat, and R-A-T spells rat, and P-A-T spells pat. The cat can't pat a rat. Cat, mat, hat, bat, and rat. It's fun to C-H-A-T chat about the family of words that end in at. There's an itty-bitty pause in the middle of a sentence. A little squiggle called a comma shows you where. So when you read a list of things, like slides, monkey bars, and swings, commas point out pauses here and there. When the song goes row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, those commas there show you where. There's a little place to put some air. Make sure you don't forget, the sentence isn't over yet. A comma's just a little break, a short pause is all you take. When there's eggs, milk, and flour in a recipe, when I sing this song to you, you, and you, that little mark will let you know how the sentence ought to flow. That's what a comma's there to do. And it's fa, like the sound at the start of phone.
Fa, 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 fa.
A phone you might use to take a photo in Phoenix with a pal named Phil. Yup, PH makes the sound of fa in any phrase, and it always will.
Fa, 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 fa.
Now it sounds exactly the same as the F in Fox and Flame, but that's PH in the middle of L. W goes O, it's a sound you've gotta know. You can hear when the crow flies low and slow, that O, W goes O. O, W goes L, you can hear that sound right now. It's the cat's meow, the dog's bow wow. Yeah, O, W goes ow. O, ow. O, W makes both sounds. So when your bowl is full of chow, or there's lots of snow to plow, tell me which two letters are you gonna need? I think you know by now, because we've shown how O-W makes both sounds. Oh, ow, yeah, O-W makes both.
Wow!
Reading words on a page is so much fun, but what do you see when a sentence is done? You've read what the sentence says, and then there's a period at the end. It's a little round dot that can't be beat, for telling you that a thought is complete. The dog plays ball, the phonies hop, the period means you stop. Feels good, right? When you're reading a storybook narration, you're gonna see some punctuation. So pause where the dot goes in, and the next sentence can begin. The whale is big, the boat is red. Stop for a second once it's been said. It's a solid rule, no passing dread. Put a period at the end. Yeah! A period at the end. You know that the sound of A-C-K is ack, ack, ack. And that a P sound added to ack will make a pack, pack, pack. And that a B sound next to ack will make your back, back, back. That's the ack, 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 we're family. Have you ever run in a race inside a sack, sack, sack? Are you craving it as an A-C-K? A snack, snack, snack.
tried hard not to step on a single crack, crack, crack. Then you know the ack, 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 we're family. Did you ever know a duck who loved to quack? Or a guy in a box whose name was Jack? Or a Western outlaw dressed in black? Or a train that's going clack, clack, clack on the track, track, track? The Ackward family. It's the Ackward family.
Eh, and E, woo wee. You got short sound of E, eh, and long sound of E, E. Two sounds of E, eh, and E. They both sound good to me. Let's go. Do you hear that eh in a word like pet? Is that the short sound of E?
You bet.
Same as you hear in a word like bell.
Hear that eh?
That's how you tell.
Pet, bet, bell, tell.
That short sound of E. But how about that long sound of E? The E sound that you hear in tree. In every sneeze, in every cheese. The long E sound is the bee's knees. Bee, knee, we all agree. That's long sound of E. Now long sound E, as you can see, often comes with a second E or a silent A in words like heat. Those E sounds can't be beat. Come on, you got short sound of E,
eh,
and long sound of E,
E.
It's short in leg, but long in knee. They're two sounds of E. When you're roping cattle by the tail, and later on you tell the tale, tail and tail are not the same. When you ride up to a mountain peak, and critters come to take a peek, peek and peak are not the same. Ooh, they're what we call homophones. Like rain and rain, they're homophones. Different words that sound the same, they're homophones. Different spellings, different meanings. Like a pair of boots and the kind of pear you're eating. Now upon your head you've got some hair, unless you've got a hair up there. Hair and hair are not the same, but what they are
homophones.
Like plain and plain, they're
homophones.
Different words that sound the same, they're tricky when you read and write. It's tough sometimes to get them right, but one day you'll know you've won when you've mastered every one of those
homophones.
Can you dig those
homophones?
When you grow bamboo, when a cow says moo, when a ghost says boo,
boo,
you're hearing a double O sound. It sounds like
ooh, ooh, ooh.
But when you take a look from a recipe book, cause you plan to cook, that's a different double O sound. It sounds like
ooh, ooh, ooh.
So let's review. You got and you got ooh. Now you know when you got double O, it's likely one of those two. Now those are the two main double O sounds, but there are a few more. Like the double O sound that you hear in flood, or the one in floor. But most of the time those double O sounds follow our usual rule. They go like in hook, or ooh, like in school. So let's review. You got
and you got ooh.
Now you know when you got double O, it's likely one of those two.
Two sounds of hi.
It's time to say hi to the two main sounds of I. There's the long I, like in kite or ice cream pie. That's the I that sounds the same as the letter's name. So come and say hi, long sound of I. But in the word kiss, or a little kitten's hiss, the I sound is short, it's an eh, just like this. Eh. When you hit a speedy pitch and rip one to the sky, that's the eh, short sound of I. Short sound eh, long sound I. You can hear both sounds when a fish jumps high. There are two sounds of I, that's no fib, no lie. So say hi to the long and short sounds of I. It might express surprise.
Whoa.
Or when someone gets hurt.
Ow.
Or a spirited call to action.
Let's go.
Or a red alert.
Look out!
If it's loud, intense, or exciting, and you're showing it in writing. Use an exclamation mark. It always adds some zip to way to go or letter rip. It's how to give a bit more punch to words like bang, boom, or crunch. If it's got that little mark, you might just want to shout it. 'Cause yippee, kapow, and holy cow just aren't the same without it. Yippee. See? Not the same. Also called an exclamation point. You hear it in Go Team. It completes a villain's curses and goes with any scream. If it's loud, intense, or exciting, and you're showing it in writing, use an exclamation mark. Well, letter P goes P, O P goes OP. Put them together, it's pop, pop, pop. Letter H goes huh, O P goes OP. Put them together, it's hop, 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 hop. We're just getting started. There's a whole OP word family. Letter B goes B, O P goes OP. Now you can bop till you drop, drop, drop. Hey. So go ahead, take a mop, 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 and wear it like a wing on your top, top, top. Let me introduce you to two sounds,
sure.
Long and short U. They're the U sounds. Short U puts the in fun underneath the summer sun. But what's that got to do with playing tug of war with a bug or giving the big duck a hug? Well, they're pretty much unrelated in all ways but one. They all make you say Verse 2 is dedicated to the long U. You know the sound. It sounds like ooh. Just think of the word flu. Or a unicorn that's super cute. You can even take words with a short U like cub. Add an E and it's cute with a long U.
What?
And some words have both sounds of U. I'm looking at you, Timbuktu.
Ooh, 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 I say ooh, ooh, ooh,
Why, baby, why? Do you need to learn about why? I'll tell you why.
Come on!
Why goes ya, e, and I? It can be a vowel or a consonant. There's so many sides of why.
Why
is a consonant in words like yarn and yellow? It makes a ya sound just for you. But it's a vowel that can sound like E when a baby loves her family. And that's not even all that it can do. Do you hear that I in a word like fly? Well, that comes from why. It's true. Let's sing it.
Why goes ya, E, and I? It can be a vowel or a consonant. There's so many sides of why.
Well, C and H, those two great letters make a whole new sound when they hook together, and the sound is ch. It's the one you'll find in the choo-choo chugging on the C and H line. When the choo-choo's coming, all the children cheer. A chimp named Charlie is the engineer. He pulls the chain on the whistle and he rings the chime on the choo-choo chugging on the C and H line. CH goes ch in chili and cheese, chimneys, churches, and cherry trees. Chubby chinchillas doing their chores. We're straight up chilling in the great outdoors. Yeah, C and H make a charming pair in words like chocolate, chicken, and chair. 'Cause together they're ch. Keep that in mind when the choo choo's chugging on the C and H line. The choo choo's chugging on the C and H line.
Of course.
Imagine if one letter could make two different sounds. Well, guess what?
What?
With letter G, that's what you got. 'Cause G makes a G, but it also makes a J. It almost feels like magic, but it's not. It's G. The most common G sound is G, as in gown.
Or goats that gobble any grass that grows.
It's at the end of twig and both ends of a guinea pig.
Yeah, that's how the G sound goes.
I think you get the gist, but hang on, there's a twist.
That G sound has got to share the stage
with that G sound that you hear,
going J, an engineer.
And when giant gerbils emerge from their cage,
it's okay, they're gentle.
Imagine if one letter could make two different sounds. Well, guess what?
What?
If you were letter G, you could.
'Cause G makes a G, but it also makes a J. That's letter G. Get it? Got it? Good.
When S is followed by H, you'll never guess what it makes.
It's
you hear it in words of all sizes and shapes.
You've heard that funny shushing sound when kids in the classroom horse around,
or when someone shouts in the library and
shh. Right, sorry about that.
But shh has many more uses than telling someone to hush.
Like when you wash a shaggy sheep and finish with a brush,
or stop in a shoe shop for a shine,
or shampoo 'cause it's shower time.
There's no shortage of words to share.
The SH sound is everywhere.
When S is followed by H, now you know what it makes.
That sh you know from words like show and ship and
shh.
Okay, but can I just finish this one song real quick?
Shh.
Oh, I and O, Y make the same oi sound in most words where they're found.
Same oi sound.
There's the oi sound that you hear in oil and shiny foil, so food won't spoil.
And when you make a choice or even raise your voice,
the O.
Same oi that we all enjoy can be spelled O-Y like a band of boys. So when you hear words with oi sounds, they must have an O-I or O-Y. And now you know why. It's 'cause
O-I and O-Y make the same oi sound in most words where they're found.
Same oi sound.
K goes K in kangaroo, in king and kite, and kid and two, but sometimes it's silent. I'll tell you when, anytime it comes before N. K is silent in a word like knee, and in it, it's quiet as can be. And there's no K sound when you're kneading dough. See that man in armor in a jousting fight? Would you call that man a knight?
No!
He's just a nut. That K has nothing to say.
K and N are together a lot in words like knuckle and knot, but it just sounds like N.
Know what I mean? I tell you again. So K goes K in kangaroo, in king and kite, and kid and two, but sometimes it's silent. I'll tell you when. Anytime it comes before N.
Anytime it comes before N.
When you drive your car to the city, you've got two sounds of C. When the cow is sipping cider, you've got two sounds of C. The hard C sound is the cut you hear in Cape and Crunch when a hero's near. The soft C sound is S, it's true, like you hear in ice and cymbals too. When a crab loves candy corn, you hear the K sound of C. When centaurs have a race, you hear the S sound of C. Check out the C's in cereal and cup, a great big cookie you eat right up. Even the bicycle you ride has two C sounds right there inside. Bicycle. Correct. In cat and circle and cake, they're certainly common as can be.
You can read about circus clowns when you know about those two sounds of C, K, and S. Meet Silent E. Here's its game. It makes a vowel, say its name, like the A in cape or the O in cone, yet it makes no sound of its own. When a kit becomes a kite, that's the work of Silent E. To make a bit a bite, you've got to add a silent E. When you see cans turn into canes,
what?
It's thanks to silent E. When you meet Jan and her friend Jane, you know that one has silent E. And as if that's not sneaky enough, it doesn't always make the vowel long. In words like love and puddle, the silent E just rides along. That silent E, you know its game. It makes a vowel, say its name, but sometimes not. It's sneaky, see?
Shh, did you hear silent E?
No, it's silent.